Welcome, friends. Today we have a session with William sir. He's come up with a very important and a captivating session of Karanas. The Karanas is a limb of Panchang, one of the limbs of Panchang, and it is connected to our professions mostly. So, sir, today we start with the Karanas and what they do and how we have to see them. Sir, welcome to Vigyavastunastrology.
Good morning. Yes, ma'am. Welcome, everybody. Okay, I'm just. This is an introduction to Karana and astrology. I'll be revealing the whole portion in our classes starting on Sunday. But I wanted everybody else to know what is Karana and profession. Very little has been talked about Karana, very few videos. So I thought after doing a small workup on PV, I thought so many people are asking more details. So I thought I'll just give it a little more bigger explanation what is Karana. The full version, I will do it in my professional course.
Okay. So for the people out there, the first session is on Sunday morning 11, but the other sessions will be on Saturday because we have shifted the class to Saturday because many are ICAs, BBB students, those who want to join and cannot join since they have classes on Saturday. Okay, sir.
So I think, Panchanga is five limbs. It has day, tithi, karana, yoga, nakshatra. Each is has five elements. The day is a fire element, tithi is water element, karana is earth, which we'll be talking about. Yoga is space element, nakshatra is air element. Each has a particular function. In fact, I've seen olden years astrology or even the village astrologer, I'm saying, they will only take this and relate it to the planetary positions and they will do. Not very stunning predictions they will have, only taking the Panchanga factors. Only the Rasi chart, not much of the Varga chart also. Just using this principle in predictive astrology. Looking into the D1 chart, but what is it? There each particular, day as a particular planetary lord, Tidhi as a lord, Karana as a lord, Yoga as a lord. These five things are very much taken. Like for Tidhi, the Moon and Venus connection is very important. For day, the sun and Mars connection is very important. Like in Karana, Mercury is the karaka for it. It's very important. They just only take this and they give stunning predictions. So I will just start off with Karana because more related with professions, just not profession, assets, wealth, a lot about the fourth house matters, it happens, and the 10th house matters. I will just try to speak about it. About this, yeah.
So, sir had taught in detail about Panchanga and Puran. He had his
book. Yeah, 10 day class we had.
And it was a super hit with the students.
Yeah. So, this is, Karana is half a tithi, which is 6 degrees. There are 2 Karanas in each tithi and 60 Karanas in a month. There are 11 types of Karanas, 4 fixed and 7 movable Karanas.
Correct.
Totally, there are 11 Karanas. See, Karana rules the earth element, is lauded by Mercury, the planet of skill and natural talents. Karana shows innate ability and skills, and if the planetary lord is well placed, it can tell about your career. See, I'm just speaking about it more detail. I'm just giving you a Karana is a lot about profession and prosperity and assets. Here, I'm just, Karana for Muhurta is a different thing. As a Panchang, you say, in predictive astrology, it has a different thing. What is it? In normal Karana, we just simply take a Bhava Karana. What are the uses of Karana? Nothing else more. But in coming to predictive astrology, a lot of other aspects are there.
Exactly.
So I'm just giving you the key factors when looking into Karana, what should be looked. When a person is born, see the first Bhava Karana is symbolized by the lion, represents the creative, fohative energy, is ruled by the planet, sun, and is lauded by the deity Indra. This is the very key aspect you will have to understand. So anybody is born in Bhava Karana, you will have to blend these three symbolism, the lion symbolism, the sun symbolism, and the Indra symbolism. Naturally, when you know when Sun and Indra mix together, a person born, I've seen these people being very bossy, very dominating, very, very strong people. And when the particular Lord Sun is well placed, well connected, they are the leaders, they are the best. I've seen people who have a well placed Sun who are also above Karana. They are the top of the bosses. In fact, Donald Trump is Bhava Karana. I will just tell you what are the example people have been Bhava Karana. Usually, because I'm relating to profession regarding leadership qualities, creativity, politics comes very well for the management skills, administration, anything where they're the CEOs, they're the bosses, where they can dominate, they can strong, they can really show their fire in them because it is Sun and Indra together. Indra is the king of the Devas. So that Indra principle and solar principles blended together, extremely very creative people. So the Bhava Karana are born to rule, to command and born to rule. Next is Balava Karana. It is actually symbolized by a tiger. Some people say cheetah, leopard. It is ruled by the planet Moon and lauded by the Adi Devata Brahma. So you know, Brahma is lion is a total different creative aspect. This is more of a productive aspect. So it has symbolized by a Brahmin lady also. So usually for what I say, or for Muhurta, they take it for all auspicious, Brahminical, Vedic purposes. So when you see, you can blend Moon and Brahma together, you can understand it is something to do with cancer related jobs, nourishing, nurturing job, with yes. Care and hospitality. And a lot of, because Brahma Tattva is there, a lot of people who produce things, manufacture things, bring out new products, create new products, all these things, people in Bhalava Karana are very good at it. We'll move to Kaulava Karana. See, this is symbolized by the measurement vessel, an animal's symbol is pig, ruled by Mars and lauded by Mitra. So naturally, when lauded by more, the clue is what I say, the planet, though the planet is taken, actually the meaning of it is more with the Adidevata. So professions involving contracts, agreements, partnership, friendship, diplomats, marriage-related works, bringing people together, those kind of diplomats, they're very, these people call over Karana, they're very, very good. Then we have Taitula Karana. This is symbolized by the donkey, ruled by Mercury and lauded by Vishwakarma. Professions, naturally, you know, Vishwakarma, the professions,
architects, and design.
Designing, planning, all civil related work, land related work, not just land related work, anything to do with blueprints, master planning, people who can do wonderful designing and planning, all these people with Taitula Karana are very good planners. I've seen the best planners and designers related to computers or constructions will most probably be a Taitula Karana. Then Gaja Karana. This is symbolized by the elephant, ruled by the planet Jupiter and lauded by Prithvi of Bhuma Devi. So naturally, when you know what is it is by Jupiter, this is usually in Muhurta, it is used for agricultural. And here it is again, farming, land, real estate, property, anything related to land-related things, Gajakarana will do very well. So anybody who has a strong Jupiter, well-placed Jupiter, will be very good with agriculture, farming, real estate, all these kind of things. Okay, this is again, another very important is Vanij Karana, symbolized by the cow, ruled by Venus and lauded by Mahalakshmi Manipatra, say Yakshakiri. So anything to do with Venus-related jobs, finance-related job, trade, entertainment, sports, hotel, creativity, aesthetics, any entertainment-related thing where a lot of finance is there, female-related things, Vanish Karana, I see. I have, for Vanish Karana, you will see Marilyn Monroe was Vanish Karana. So, and makes, actually a lot of characteristics also is given. I'm just relating to the professional aspect of Vanish Karana. Vishti Karana. I have a lot to say. Many people think Vishti Karana is a very negative Karana. But when it comes to astrological predictions, you will see Vishti is not actually negative. Because you will see our prime minister is Vishti Karana.
Okay.
And most of the top astrologers I have seen are Vishtikarana. It's an astrologer's thing. I've seen many astrologers being born in Vishtikarana.
So here's the difference, like Vishti should not be used in Murata, but it is a good karana to have for professions.
Professions. Well, if the Lord is well placed, well, it is very good.
Correct.
See, it is as symbolized by the hen. Hen, you know what the hen does, no? It keeps on searching for grain. Correct. So I have seen very good people who can do a lot of research.
Research
people. And it's lauded by Yama. They're very good with insurance, medicine, investigation. They could be very good detectives. These kind of things, they're very, very good. And mostly I've seen, I'm just showing the examples. I have about four astrologers, top astrologers, I just picked up who are Vishtikaranas. Very, very easy to have people to have Vishtikaranas. Okay, just a second. Okay, then we have Shakuni. Shakuni is symbolized by an eagle and ruled by the planet Rahu and lauded by from this last four is actually Sthira Karana. It's supposed to be a negative Karana from Murta because most of them are ruled by Rahu and Ketu. Your profession related to poison, medicines, tantra, magic, healing, all these people related tantric works, magic, all these people will be there. But again, it's because Rahu related work, latest technologies, path-making technology. People are very good, they are troubleshooters, very good at solving problems. Anybody who can talk and solve a problem, mediate a problem, you can always see they are belonging to Shaguni. Most of the famous diplomats will have Shaguni. Then we have Chatushpat. This is symbolized by a four-legged dog, animal ruled by Kedu and lauded by Rudra or Nandishwara. Most of the animal lovers, people who deal with animals, veterinarians, are mostly you can and see them. They're very good at weather also. Many politicians you will see that people in professional government related thing are in Chatushpada. The next, Naga. Naga symbolized by a snake ruled by Rahu and lauded by Nagas. Profession related to sneezing, catching, seizing, in works. This is something related to Asnesha, related jobs. What I say, most of these jobs is done by Naga. You come to Kinstubna. It is symbolized by an insect, moth, or worm, ruled by Kedu and lauded by Maruts. Kinstubna, it's slightly different for Shukla Paksha and Krishna Paksha. For Shukla Paksha, it's supposed to be a very lucky thing, a lot to do with financial expansion, progress works. Many people are very lucky, I've seen, especially the Shukla Paksha Kinstubna. It is supposed to be a very auspicious, if it is in Shukla Paksha, because it is ruled by Maruts and Kubera. This is just an introduction on what is the main planetary rod and the Graha Devada. I will just go a little deeper to explain to the other aspects also. Okay, we have explained it. Okay, so now the Karana Lord in different houses, what does it mean? Okay, Karana Lord, this is something equal to the 10th Lord being in each house. You can understand it like that. See, Karana Lord in Lagna, if it is a benefit, it depends because it's in Lagna, you rise in life by strong, perseverance, determination, leadership qualities, the very authoritative, independent, high status, pioneer, founder of institutes, work colleagues, state conscious. It's very similar, like if you see your AMK, in these houses, or you see this is one of the aspects. Either AMK you can take the 10th Lord, or when it is in these houses. So one of the other aspects, there are many ways of seeing profession.
Okay.
One very important, Karana also has a vital role in understanding. Kar is to do with karma. So what you steer to and what's your destiny is very. There's a very big hint on where the Karana Lord is placed. So Karana Lord in the second house is to do with earnings, communications, skills, about looks, about family trade, hotel business, mostly anything to do with finance and communication things. So people with Karana in the second house will be. Karana in the second house, third house is mostly you will see they have extraordinary strength and valor, sportsmen, especially you must relate it. This is a very general thing. You must see what is the planet. If it as the house, if it is Mars and Sun or a fiery planets, naturally sports professions will come out. Competitive example. If it is Venus, Moon as Karana Lord in the third house, they can
be musician,
arts, artistic, very skilled, talented people. Technicians if Mars. It is just a general thing. Depending on the planet, who's a Karana Lord in the particular house, we'll have to understand it.
Right.
Karana Lord, the fourth house. They are head of a large organization, good reputation, pious general, royal favors, agricultural pursuits, and fourth house to do with vehicles. So Venus is the Karana Lord in the fourth house. It'll do with vehicles. If Mars is the Karana Lord in the fourth house, a lot of land related, agriculture related will be very strong. Jupiter in the fourth house, banking related things will be there. So you will have to, think which is the planet. Yes, ma'am. So Karana Lord in the fifth house, connected to children, status, colleges, college, amuse park. Mostly if it is status and if it is Venus. Mercury is to do with Mercury and Jupiter is related to colleges. If it is Sun, it could be drama, movies, all these kind of things. Mercury is there, Rahu is there, speculation will be a lot. So you'll have to relate which planet is and bring it together. Okay, now Karana Lord in the sixth house. They're service oriented, work for others, very hard workers. If it is mostly Jupiter or Mars, one is a doctor, army. If it is Mars, it is army personnel, police. If it is Saturn, it is advocate, legal will be there. Mars and Sun, it's deaths, enemies, they can have also, they can be a doctor or also have problems with it. Karana Lord in the seventh house. Naturally, good prospects after marriage, foreign settlements, profits through partnership, alliance contracts, like that. But it's very important in the seventh house. It should not be a malefic sitting over there. Mostly, it should be Venus, Moon, Jupiter. If it is there, it is good. Or it will be the other opposite, or it could have problems related to these things. So it's better in certain houses, benefics are placed. Karana Lord in the eighth house is generally not very, very good. But again, if it is well placed and well associated, you will have secret service, detective, spy, insurance, medical network, undertaker, secret earnings, researcher, excavation work, inheritance, undercurrent money, and many other people. If afflicted, you can they can be a very dependent people, not working, no working, commits crime, or it can be negative. The karma becomes very negative, especially if the Karana Lord is in the sixth sector. But if well associated, even in the eighth house, most of the doctors I've seen, people in the research field will have Karana Lord in the eighth house. Karana Lord in the ninth house, they can be highly very educated. They can be ministers, big philanthropists, healers, teachers, spiritual related people. They could be priests or head of an institution. They can be very well. This is all very. This is not a general. If they are benefics or well associated, all this happens. If it is negative, replace it. It will be away from all these things. Okay. And Karana Lord in the 10th house is one of the best to have in the horoscope. A philanthropic, torchbearer, dignified, supports family. They are mostly big politicians and lead very powerful posts. Very, very successful. Again, just not Karana Lord in the 10th house. It must be powerful, a good planet, and well associated planet. We go to the Karana Lord in the 11th house. It's very lucky for finance related things. They gain from other family business. There are many friends. It's mostly a self-employed business. I've seen many people in Karana Lord in the 11th house to do with entertainment business, something to do with relaxation, partying, or hotel related things. They have a lot, huge friends. Again, this depending on the planets. But most of the Karana Lord, even the malefic here, will do quite good. Then Karana Lord in the 12th house, if it is afflicted, they can be very dependent, spendthrift, not having much money. But generally, Karana Lord, well associated, benefit Karana Lord. They work outside the country, traveling job, export business, hospital, jails, NGOs. They can be very extravagant. So this is a general thing of Karana Lord in the 12 houses. Now, most important thing, I will come to Karana Lord in different tattva rasis. See, Karana Lord, you must know, it's an earth element, lauded by Mercury. So you can very easily say Karana Lord is very good in an earthy sign. And Karana Lord is also good in a watery sign because it's friendly sign. Karana Lord in fire sign, it is mixed results depending on the occasion. Karana Lord in the airy sign can be difficult. But before I'll come, I'll just give you what could be the probable professions. Karana Lord in fiery sciences, they are motivated, goal-oriented, love to be in spotlight, involved in profession related to fire, iron, metals, weapons. They are the bosses, CEOs, managers, especially if it's Bhava Karana, falling in your factory employees, electric job, defense and police, electrical, other power-related jobs. You know the fire, what is it? Karana Lord in fire signs can be, I'll come to that aspect later, but it will give a very strong job. In earthy signs, Karana Lord in earthy signs is extremely very good. They're very practical, steady, plodding, hardworking people, very grounded. Usually things related to agriculture, botanists, statistician, architects, financial manager, dietists, administrators. You can see Karana Lord in an earthy sign. Karana Lord in earthy sign is very, very lucky, especially if it is Venus, Moon, or Jupiter. In an earthy sign, it can be one of the most best combination in the horoscope. Karana Lord in airy sign is actually very challenging because the Karana by itself, an earthy planet, can create powers, but if it is well placed, or what I say, they can give intellectual jobs, scientists, social workers. People use the mind and intelligence, a lot of analysis and logic if they use. Professors, advocates, librarians, pilots, you can see. Karana Lord in watery sign is very, very good. Naturally, the people will have very empathetic, caring, and helping jobs. Social workers, financial advisors, landscapers, nurse, veterinarian, therapist, guarantee that the soft goes all any water, liquid related things, textile, fabric, is anything related to moon related things. You would say Karana Lord. Karana Lord in earth sign and water signs is very, very auspicious. I'll explain it as a summary. See, Karana Lord in earthy signs, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, gives very auspicious results. Karana Lord in watery signs, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, give very fruitful, fertile results. This goes with the nature of the Karana Lord. An earthy, it's an earthy lord, so naturally in an earthy and watery sign, it does well. It's not good for an earthy planet to be in an airy sign. It just blows off. So it can be challenging for Karana Lord in an air sign, especially Karana Lord in air sign with the Dustana, with malefic planets, can be very difficult. And Karana Lord in fiery signs, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, can also give mixed results. It depends on the combination. The same way, Karana Lord with Mercury, because Mercury is a Karana Lord, in a Kendra Kona, it gives very good professional success. Karana Lord in Jupiter is also very good. Gives abundance, wisdom, knowledge. Karana Lord with Venus and Moon in Kendra Kona, very good, very not just comfortable career, will give a very high rise, can be very prosperous, very rich. The very best combination, especially Karana Lord, Venus and Moon in an earthy, watery sign. Karana Lord in Rahu and Saturn, again, you know, they're both airy planets. It's an earthy, it is not good. So Karana Lord with Sun, Mars, Ketu will give mixed results depending on the sign it is. So if they are both, the last two things are in 6, 8, 12 houses, can be very challenging. So depending on the houses it is, this will change. Okay, this will come to current. This Karana Lord, each Karana Lord, one particular dasa will be very good, one particular dasa will be very bad. So naturally, it is not a standard prediction, you can't blindly apply it. You'll have to know to an extent, it should be good. If the planet which I mentioned is good, is really well placed, it will give excellent results. If it is mediocrely placed also, it will give good results. The only thing, if it is badly placed, it may not give the promise which is promised there. So it is generally Bhava Karana, Sun Dasa will be good, Jupiter Dasa will be excellent, and Venus Dasa will be challenging. Balava Karana, Moon Dasa will be good, Venus Dasha will be the best, and Saturn Dasha will be challenging. In Mars Dasha, in Kaulava Karana, Mars Dasha will be good, Saturn Dasha will be the best, and Rahu Dasha will be challenging. In Taithulya Karana, Mercury Dasha will be good, Rahu Dasha will be the best, and Kedu Dasha will be challenging. In Garij Karana, Jupiter Dasha will be good, Kedu Dasha will be the best, and Sun Dasha will be challenging. In Vanij Karana, Venus Dasha will be good, Sun Dasha will be the best, and Moon Dasha will be challenging. In Vishti Karana, Saturn Dasha will be good, Moon Dasha will be the best, and Mars Dasha will be challenging. In Shaguni Karana, Rahu Dasha will be good, Mars Dasha will be the best, and Mercury Dasha will be challenging. In Nagava Karana, Rahu Dasha will be good, Mars Dasha will be best, and Mercury Dasha will be challenging. In Tachushpada, Kedu Dasha will be good, Mercury Dasha will be best, and Jupiter Dasha will be challenging. In Kimstugna, Kedu Dasha will be good, Mercury Dasha will be the best, and Jupiter Dasha will be challenging. I'll be explaining this with a lot of example in the professional class. I'll just give you one example. You know, our Prime Minister is Vishti Karana. And you know when, which Dasha he became the Prime Minister? Twice he won. It was in his Moon Dasha. It was his Moon Dasha. It was Sade Sati also.
Yes.
Why Sade Sati was good for him? Because he's a Vishti Karana. Vishti Karana is ruled by Saturn. Sade Sati did not do anything. So Vishti Karana people, Saturn functioning will be different for Vishti Karana people. You for them, Vishti Karana, Sade Sati can do good. And was his Moon Dasha also. This is one example. I will explain
very
for each chart.
Important point, sir. Mostly, when we are doing profession or we are even reading the charts, most of them don't even take the Karana into consideration.
Yeah.
So, these classes, I think so much just in 10 or 20 minutes. So, we have full 10 sessions. I don't know how much, so much points you will be giving out.
Correct.
I hope people will come and join. Sir is going to take D1, D9, D10, D60 in detail concerning each and every profession. Without D60, sir says you cannot decode a chart for profession. And he's going to show us so many examples. More than 300 charts are already done by him. Many come in during the sessions given by students, which sir also takes. So I think this is going to be a great class.
Are we also using the Atmakaraka, Avitya Karaka, the Karaka?
Yeah, Jamini,
Atmakaraka. Or roles for every chart and explaining how it connects to the chart. The Ashtavaraka also, I forgot. How Ashtavaraka can be a snapshot, way to understand what profession can be.
Great.
So many people will ask, I've done a remedial, detailed remedial measures course. But yeah, the remedial measure is profession related, or let's say, what I say, the Karana Lord. If you worship the Karana Lord alone, it will, what I say, give you professional success. It's very, very important to identify what is each Karana. As we saw, there is a particular Devada for the Karana. So the Graha Devada and the Adi Devada, when it is worshipped, what I say, it elevates the profession. Like if you pray to the Tidhi Lord, it is good for marriage related things.
Marriage.
You pray to the Day Lord, it's good for health. A Nakshatra Lord is good for all other purposes. Same way when praying to the Karana Lord, it is supposed to give you... Yesterday I put a post on this and people didn't understand it. I think it was very new to them. So I did a separate page, a little more detail on how to...
Sir, there is a question. Yeah. Like, yeah. Suppose we take the Devta. Suppose these planets or Grah Devtas are... Three houses Devtas, then still we go ahead and...
Yes. Because you'll have to appease them. They are negatively placed.
Okay.
So what I say, see, they become the rulers of our profession related things. Even if they are afflicted, so it'll do some appeasement. If it is placed well, what I say, it is more better.
Yes. So I think this question would come up in
yes,
after definitely. The session. Yes, yes. So,
no, because this is very much related to Karana and Adi principles. So,
okay.
Yeah. What I explained to you, see, because Karana Devata is a earthy thing, the worship is more of offering food. So what is it? To the Devata, I've also mentioned the food offering also for this. So offering food will be the main thing. Yes, mantra, you are going to this related temple on this, but you must go on the Karana Devata day only. To this particular thing, and I've given you a food offering, a flower offering, and a dress offering to be given. Most important is the food offering, because Karana Lord is only pleased by food.
Okay.
What is
and
it?
Sir, because, like, say, suppose Balava, you have written Adi Devta is Brahma. And generally, we don't pray to Lord Brahma, right?
You can it's actually Prajapati, or you can go to that particular thing to a Vishnu temple.
Okay.
You can, because he's the same principle, creative principle only. If you do not find anything, you can go to a Vishnu temple.
Correct. No, but if they have something like Prajapati or Brahma,
look, see, commonly you can take, like, what I say, you can go to a Shiva temple or Vishnu temple. If you do not have, go to a Shiva Vishnu temple on the mentioned days with the food offering is most
food correct. Offerings. Okay.
Mantras alone, maybe the Gayatris are there, you can chant the Gayatri. Brahma Gayatri is there. Yes, Brahma Gayatri can be chanted.
Okay.
See, Graha Devata, Surya for Bhava, and Adi Devata is Indra. You have Surya Gayatri, Indra Gayatri. You can say the Surya Namaskar mantras, Yajurveda Surya Namaskar, many mantras are there. Food offering is pongal, rice gruel, is Alexandrian laurel as a flower. A dress offering is a white cloth. What I say? Naturally, on the Karana day, Bhava Karana day, you'll have to go to a Surya temple, or you can even go to a Shiva temple. If you're not able to get, you can go to preferably an east facing Shiva temple and do an offering. If you, or you can go to the Navagrahas and offer it to Surya.
Ah, right. Correct.
This regular going to it, one thing I forgot to mention. I mentioned you the animal symbols for each thing. I've seen people locally in my place, what they do is, you want a product, product symbol. They're asking, what is the symbol of the Karana Lord?
Right.
You have to use that particular symbol or some energy related to the symbol. Some people, you know, they even advise to keep the, let's say lion is a symbol. They're asking to keep lion as your screensaver or something to watch it. Particularly. Each are given, it's supposed to somewhere energize your professional aspects. So there's one very big advice I've seen in South. Many people will look at the Karana Lord, lion is a Karana. They say you at least few minutes every day look at a lion. As for the professional, if you want to keep a symbol of a professional thing, keep the Karana Lord symbol or something related to, not exactly a symbol. You've seen NGM lion symbol, no? I don't know. You must be Bhava as Karana. So the symbol is very much, that energy is very related to profession. As Yoni is related to marriage, the Karana symbolism is very much related. You can use the symbol as a picture, saver, or that it energizes your Karana. Another way of energizing Karana. And one more thing, what is a gemstones related to the Karana Lord? Because Karana is an earth element, and a gem is an earth element. The Karana Lord's gem worn, it will be very good results. Because what I say, let's say your fifth planet or ninth lord is a watery planet, and gemstone may not work. Usually, gemstone works very well for an earthy planet, earthy sign lord. Here, Karana by itself is an earthy lordship. So, wearing a gem will give the best, especially whatever is your Karana lord, wearing gems for that will be the best. So, I think everybody knows what is.
So, again, if the Karana lord is trick house, then also.
I think also because it strengthens. It does strengthen, because you have to strengthen your profession. I think it's not a problem. The only thing, if it's left, if it is in the three houses, wear it in your left hand. If it's in your in a good house and a good placement, wear it in the right. And for to strengthen the Karana Lord, only wear it in the ring finger, because the ring finger is an earthy element. So you have to strengthen the earthy aspect of the element, you can wear it in the earthy.
What if they are with, like, say, malefics, like now they do, or maybe?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Wear it in the left hand. It balances. Left. If it is negative, look at 6, 8, 12, if you're finding it difficult, you can wear it to the left.
Okay.
The right strengthens, left balances.
Correct.
So, we come to Balava Karana. The Graha Devata is Chandra. Adi Devata is Brahma. Food offering is Payasam. I think everybody knows what's payasam. It's a kind of sweet rice gruel. Flower offering is magnolia champaka. Dress offering is a red cloth. What is it? So going to on a Balava Karana, you can pray to Chandra or you can pray to Brahma. In Shiva temple, you get Brahma behind. Or you can pray to Shivaya.
Ma Parvati.
Chandra, you can pray to Parvati. Chandra mantras are there, Brahma Gayatri is there.
Yes.
You can chant.
Yes.
And Kalua Karana, Graha Devada is Mars, Angaraka, and Adidevada is Mitra. So usually it was given as sweet appa. And slightly the books are given for, if it is Krishna Paksha, it is spicy appam, and for Shukla Paksha has sweet appam. So what is it? So I've just mentioned that sweet. Actually, the thing is appam first. Appam is a Kerala dish, so a small, like idli it will be.
Right.
What is it? Then the flower offering is a Maulsuri or bulletproof. Dress offering is, it's actually a cotton sari. It's called a Kandangi sari. Very famous. This is supposed to be the localized this they are supposed to offer. Okay. And for Garija, did I finish everything? Taitulya, Graha Devata's Buddha, and Avideva Vishwakarma. Food offering is appam here also. Flower offering is jasmine. Death offering is a yellow color cloth. Here, you're chanting of Narayana Upanishad, Purusha Suktam, Vishnu Sastram, Narayana Suktam. Any Vishnu related things Vishnu can be done. If you are Vishwakarma, you are more related to Vishnu. So any Vishnu related Vishnu temples, one can go on Taitula Karana for strengthening the profession. Then Garij Karana, Graha Devada's Brihaspati, and Adi Devada's Prithvi or Vishwadeva. So usually, I think you are in Vastu, ma'am. In Garij Karana, to do Vastu related remedies is the best because it is ruled by Prithvi. Usually, what I said, the day when Vastu is awake, people do a Vastu related things. Every month, one day Vastu is awake. One more day, it is very good, is Garija, because ruled by Prithvi. To do to Ganapati or to put to Vastu Devata or to Prithvi or Bhuma Devi is very good on Garija Karana. So usually here is a food offering is mint, flower offering is hibiscus, dress offering is a black cloth. I've mentioned, and also Bhuvaraha. There is one particular puja called Bhuvaraha puja. It's very good for land.
Yes. Those who don't get, those who are finding it difficult to, they want a property, but from many years they are not getting, then they can recite this Bhuvaraha mantra. It is one of the best mantras, and you do it systematically with sankalp and everything. I give this remedy to so many people.
Sukta is there, mantra is there. Usually they do it in Swadhi Nakshatra, but it is very good when you do it in the Karana because it's an earth element.
Correct. So people can go with this Kuvara mantra if they are finding it difficult to get a property.
Yeah. Yes, especially right. Property related things. On this is very, very good.
Correct.
Then we have Vanija, Graha Devata Shukra, Anadi Devata Mahalakshmi, Kubera, or any money related gods. What is the food offering is curd, flower offerings is, I'm not able to get the exact, it's called Neel Lochana. So it's a blue color flower. I think it is a blue lily.
Blue lily, yes.
The dress offering is a woolen cloth. So praying to Ichha Shakti Devi, which is like Kavachi, chanting Lalita Sahasrama, Mahalakshmi, Kubera, chanting Sri Shuktam, Bhakti Shuktam, strengthens Vanish Karana. Naturally, going to a Vishnu temple is good. Mahalakshmi is the main. Naturally, you have Mahalakshmi Kubera. Is not there. Kubera's Mola Mantra is there. Kubera Gayatri is there. Mahalakshmi Gayatri is there. Mahalakshmi Ashtodha, Sarsrama, all that can be chanted. Actually, for anybody, it's not just for Vanish Karana. Any money related you want to do a Lakshmi Puja on a Vanish Karana. You will get lots. If people want to do any Devi Puja, do it on a Vanish Karana. You want money, prosperity in the house, Vanish Karana, do a puja. Go to a Devi temple, Mahalakshmi temple on a Vanish Karana. It'll improve your money more than any other thing because it's not just profession related. It's an earth element. It's related to assets and properties. So if anybody wants to go to a temple, choose Vanish Karana if you want money, prosperity, to increase. If it is land related, go on Garish Karana. But you want money related, yeah, it is on a Vanish Karana. And especially if you are Vanish Karana, it becomes very auspicious to increase your wealth because it comes very nicely to you. So going on a Vanish Karana will be the best. Okay. Yeah, again, Vishti Karana. Graha Devata Sani, Adi Devata Yama, Amriti. Everybody is scared of this. Nobody uses this as a Muhurta. People ask me how to pray to Yama. Actually, praying to Kala Bhairava, chanting Ayush, Mrityunjaya mantras is very good on Vishnu. You can also chant the Rutram also on this day. Generally, you can go to a Shiva temple, it's the best. In fact, in my place, there are a lot of temples where Shiva had sanctified by getting over Yama.
Right.
What is it? Those kind of temples, if you go, it is very, very good. Then food offering is mixed food, not just a single food. It's like a cocktail of foods. Flower offering is, it's supposed to be adenanthira, pavanoid flower, or it's a red bead flower. You know this, what is it? The bead, no? You call it red and black. That particular flower, that you will have to use. Dress offering is tiger skin. The Graha Deva, this is the thing, you'll have to go on Vishtikarna. So anybody who's born in Vishtikarna, see, you always see if it is well placed. I have an example chart, maximum shown in Vishti. Vishtikarna can be, but if it's negative, this can be also the very bad Karana. In fact, Vijay Malia is born in Vishtikarna. Then you have Sharada Mata, also born in Vishtikarna. So, but you have very successful people also born in Vishtikarna. Rishtigant is born, I think Sachin Tendulkar is born in Vishtikarna. So very successful people also are born. If the planet is well placed, or if it's because it is guarded by Sunny has to be really very, very, very good.
Yeah.
Okay, then for Shakuni, people who are born on Shakuni. In fact, the last four karanas are generally negative karanas. It's not for professional. In fact, for even shaping their destiny, making it better, even as a parigar, even a small kid is born in the last four, because the last four karanas are only during Chaturdasi and Amasa. So what is it becomes like a just born baby is born. It is very, very important to do on this karana remedial measures. It is very important. Because the Chaturvesi and Amavasya Karanas are ruled by only Rahu Ketu. So it becomes the Tidhi Lord is bad and the four Karana Lord also bad. All the fixed Karanas are lorded by only Rahu Ketu. So that's why Chaturvesi is extremely very, very bad. In fact, Chaturvesi bonds, they have a Dagda Tidhi for four Rasis. All the taller Rasis becomes their Dagda.
Yes.
So here, what I say, actually, Sattva Shanti is generally done on Ashesh Nakshatra, Panchami Tidhi. One more thing they can use is Shakuni and Nagava Karana shall be. On a Nagava Karana, Shakuni, people, not just what I say, if they are born, anybody having Rahu Kedu in negative houses in the chart, if they want to do a remedy, best is to do on a Nagava Karana or Shakuni Karana. Nationally, Sarpa Shanti, Sarpa Bali, praying to Kali, all this wrathful female goddess praying to it, it's very, very good. The food offering is jaggery, flower offering is magnolia champaka, dress offering it is usually you have to donate old clothes on Shakuni Day. It's a remedy. Okay, Nagava is very similar. The food offering is ghee appam, flower offering is ole flower, dress offering is a tree dress made of bark. This is a Trisuparna mantra which comes in Narayana Upanishad. It should be very good for Nagava. Any sarpa related Navanaga mantra, sarpa mola mantras, Rahu mantras, praying to Subramanya also is very, very good. So Subramanya is the antidote for sarpa. So going to Subramanya temple is also very good. Any stake temple, if they go, it is very good. People born on this, or even as people who have Sarpa Dosha remedy, to Shaguni and Nagava is very, very good. Okay, then Chatushpada and Kim Stubra are both Kedu. Graha Devadas Kedu, Adi Devadas Mani Bhatra, Rudra, Kshetrapalakas and Bhairava. Food offering is honey, flower offering is a killer flower, dress offering is a dress made of leaves. Praying to Ganapati and Rudra is extremely very, very auspicious for us. People who have Kedu badly placed in their chart can do their remedies on Chatushpada and Kimstaka. Kedu in the 8th house, 12th house, Kedu afflicting moon, Kedu with any planet will bring down the effect of a planet. So the best is on Chatushpada, and because there is no day for Kedu. So the, what it says, so the best day for Rahu Kedu is to do it on Shaguni and Agava, or for Kedu is to do on a Chatushpada and Kimstu. The particular offering which is given is very good. What is it? Kimstugna, food offering is sugar, flowering offering is something called kombu, dress offering is an upper portion of cloth. You have a vastram, no? An offering, that particular cloth. The Devadas Vayu, so Vayu Sutram and Hanuman temple is very good. People born in Kimstugna. So this strengthens, this is not just a general thing. Anybody born on this particular karana, going to this temple and doing this remedial measure strengthens the profession. You have the weak profession, or you want to elevate or increase the profession, it is very good to do all these things.
Super remedies are very good. I don't think so. We have done this in remedy session.
No. I'm not.
I think people will be very glad to see this session of yours.
Yeah.
It's been a long time we have had a session, and you have come up with a superb one.
One last thing, I'm just giving you certain examples of also people born. Just I'll do this detail of the planetary. There's one more thing which I've not told is how to apply it in the horoscope. So there's some more role. I'm just giving you a general introduction, what is karana and how it is done. But interpreting the horoscope, you have to see the planetary portion by the karana and relate it to many other factors. But this is just an introduction for them to know what is karana. How does it work? How much karana lord can have an influence on profession? So, for as an introduction, we'll be doing. Maybe we'll do a separate webinar on taking the planetary portion in detail with a lot of example charts. But we'll be doing it in the profession completely. All the 300 charts, I'll be using karanas and their relation with how a karana is related to a profession. See, karana is actually the skill of a person, a talent of a person, aptitude of a person. So even if a karana lord is not well placed, that particular karana lord gives the skill. If he's well connected and well placed, it becomes a profession. It becomes a career. Or he has the skill, he has the aptitude, he has the proficiency. It must be related to good house to become a profession. So you have, as I said, Baba Karna, very dominant people, Donald Trump, George Bush Jr., Benito Mussolini, Dhirubhai Ambani, Albert Einstein, Lara Dutta. See, both the pioneers and the best in astrology, B.V. Rao and K.N. Rao, both are Baba Karna. Then you have Balava Karna, it's ruled by Moon, Brooke Shields, Diana, Bill Clinton, Mahatma Gandhi, or Balava Karna. Kalwa is Mars, Arnold Schwarzenegger, Dwayne Johnson, Franklin Roosevelt, Indira Gandhi, Rajiv Gandhi, Tom Cruise, all the masculine energy you can see in Kalwa Karna. Taitu Karana is Mercury, the speed, you can see Boris Becker, Bill Gates, is Mercury is in the fourth house, Bill Gates,
yes.
Dhoni, his Lagna Lord is Mercury, Elon Musk, Sigmund Freud, he's a psychiatrist, has the Mercury as the ruling Lord, Garija, Jupiter for finance, J.R.R. Tata, King George, Steve Jobs, and Jupiter is well placed with Garija Karana, you can be one of the richest persons in the world. The most prettiest people in the world, Marilyn Monroe, Pamela Anderson. There's a Florence Gifford Joyner. She's a sprinter. She used to put lipstick and she decorate herself and under her. Why? Because she's born in Vanija Karana. Vishti, I'm just Narendra Modi, Cameron Dias, Elvis Presley, Jawaharlal Nehru, Oprah Winfrey, Sachin Tendulkar, Sharda Mata. See, Sanjay Gandhi. If it is negative in place, you can see Sanjay Gandhi is Warren Buffett, Rajnikanth, Vijay Mallya. If it's badly placed, yes, Vishti can be bad. Then you will not get, people cannot cite with Vishti. Even the best, you have the two prime ministers of a country, Vishti Karana only. And then you can see how many astrologers are just randomly picked. You have K.S. Krishnamurti of KP Astrology, Narasim Rao of Jagannath Ahura, C.S. Patel, Vishti Larsen, Neelakanta, very famous Neelakanta Sharma. I've just mentioned randomly had for my class, I have 10 astrologers. I just looked at them. After them, 4 are Vishti Karmas. Shakuni is Serena Williams, Tiger Woods. Nagava is Marlon Brando, Zarina Afshar. Naturally, they have the hypnotic look. It can be very mesmerizing look, like Marlon Brando, Chatushpada is Parvez Musharraf. So these are the examples. All of them in detail, their planetary portion, the Karna Lord, which house, how you take the planetary position and interpret, I will be taking in the professional class. This I've just given you an introduction. For 300 horoscope, we'll see in detail in the professional class.
Very beautiful, sir. This class is really amazing. Friends, do go over and watch this video and comment in the comment box which karana are you and which is the profession that you have chosen. So you also get a lot of remedies if your profession is not going well. You can take the remedies, sir, as mentioned, and you can strengthen your karana lord. Karana lord is one of the important factors for profession, just as the 10th lord, lakna lord, and D10, D9. Sir, thank you for this beautiful session. Very beautiful session.
Sure. Thank you.
And all the best. Everybody. Yeah, all the best for our course, which is starting on Sunday. People do join if you want to learn all about profession. Sir has mentioned so many professions and we'll be taking more. Thank you. See you on Sunday.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.